station, and I wanna be a part of the Atari sensation. Rather play some Donkey Kong, and Pete's working all day long.
If the world was one big dog, all I need is me and my Atari.
I can remember, I've always wished I could have been a computer programmer in the early 80s. Instead, I was a baby. Fortunately, now I can pretend to live my dream in the 21st century with Basic Programming, released in 1979 for the Atari 2600.
Jen's playing Basic Programming on an Atari 7800, modded for crystal clear S video output and improved audio quality through a dedicated audio output. The Atari 7800 is backwards compatible, so it can play all of your favorite 2600 games, as well as high-tech 8-bit 7800 games with more detail and colorful graphics.
I asked for a car, I got a computer. How's that for being born under a bad sign?
The late 70s and early 80s were a magical time when personal computers were just starting to be a thing. And anyone who knew how to use them was like a member of a secret club that you had to be really smart to get into.
Do you know, I put together that entire project, including the presentation slides, just this morning.
Had your whole department working on it, huh?
No, I used my new Lisa personal computer.
A personal computer did all that?
That's right.
Incredible.
Nowadays, any schmuck with an iPhone and a YouTube account can program something a million times better than what the most powerful computer was capable of in 1979. It was a simpler time, when people sent letters through the mail and did all their research using an outdated set of Encyclopedia Britannicas. Back then, game manufacturers tried to market their consoles to the whole family by making them perform other functions like word processing and personal finance. Wow, when little Timmy is done playing Space Invaders, Dad can use the same system to balance his checkbook.
With the Commodore VIC-20, the whole family can learn computing at home. Plays great games, too.
One such attempt by Atari was Basic Programming, which let the average Joe build computer programs just like the pros by the glow of an analog TV. Basic is an early programming language designed for beginner computer users. It was developed at a time when computers were big, scary things that everyone was afraid would take over and ultimately destroy the world, the 1960s. Just watch any episode of the original Star Trek or The Twilight Zone and you'll see what I mean.
This whole society is a machine's concept of perfection. Peace, harmony,
but no so.
Variations of BASIC remained in use by casual programmers well into the 90s, including the popular Visual BASIC, which eventually found its way into business applications. Many computer programming students began by studying BASIC, or Pascal, a similar language which yours truly learned in high school. If you're still watching, you're either seriously nerdy or you fell asleep with YouTube still open. If you're a member of the former category, pay attention. Here comes the fun part, programming.
I'm rather busy, actually. I've just succeeded in computer generating a parrot onto the screen.
My congratulations. Whatever next?
It squawks.
To use the basic programming cartridge, you need a set of these. Atari keyboard controllers. Yes, you actually need both controllers. Individually, they look like two useless number pads. But with their powers combined, you have one chunky keyboard. The next step is to apply the overlays, which display the different commands each button performs. These are impossible to find, so I printed mine from the internet, then painstakingly cut out all of those stupid little circles, only to find that they didn't fit. so now I just use them as a reference. As you can see, the limited number of keys on the controllers means each key performs up to 4 color-coded functions. You switch between functions by pressing the Shift Control key, this colorful circle of arrows on the bottom of the left controller. For example, the letter J is blue on the right controller. So to press J, you will have to press the Shift Control key until the cursor turns blue, then press the J key. This process is even slower than texting on a phone number pad and takes some getting used to. Still with me? Okay, let's start programming. The manual lists instructions for a simple program to help you get the hang of it. Let's give it a shot. Change the cursor to the blue mode and push the A key. Okay, white, red, blue, A, okay. Now change the cursor to the red mode and push the left arrow key. Green, white, I guess that's supposed to be red, it looks like brown. Go back to blue and input B. Blue, B. Change to red and input plus and the number 2. Red plus 2. Input print using the green mode. Red, blue, green. And then print. Okay. And then A. Alright, I'm running my first program. Here we go.
Die. Kill. Die.
Is that what it's supposed to do? Output.
Die, Jesus.
Output. Oh! There it is. Let's try it again.
Pet Cemetery by Stephen King.
One. Two. It's working! Three. Faster. Yeah. Five. Six. Seven. 8, 9, where's 9? There it is, yeah! I did it!
You done with the TV yet? I want to play some Neo Geo. This is boring.
Wow, I just took 20 minutes to display 10 numbers on the screen. I'm a computer programmer. Let's try another one. Note? Whoa, I can take 20 minutes to play a couple of music notes? I gotta try this.
Hey, when you're hungry, there's nothing like a box of raisins. They're nature's candy, I'd always say.
If.
Sun-made raisins.
Note. If note.
This still?
Ah! I'm gonna make it play music. Eventually.
I wanna watch Deep Space Nine.
Then. Where's then? Then is green.
This looks like crap.
Come on, I'm programming with my Atari. Isn't this exciting?
We have an Xbox 360. Why don't you play that?
Because you can't do basic programming with an Xbox 360.
You want some ravens?
No, thank you.
Good luck.
And then, not six.
Got a new record. It's by Aha.
Wow.
Should put it on.
Well, first listen to this.
They do that Take On Me song, you know?
Uh-huh.
That's a good one.
Six. Okay. Let's try it again. ringing!
Cut that racket off. Good job, honey.
Holy crap, computer technology really is amazing. Let's see if I can make it play something else.
Atari 2600. You can make all kinds of programs, from words to graphics and even games, but you don't have to take my word for it.
Teddy did it!